Welcome to a presentation on average value. The goal of this video is to find the average value of a function. The definition for the average value of a function on a given interval is as follows. If you let y sub av equal the average value of the function, it will be equal to 1 divided by b minus a times the definite integral from a to b of f of x dx. One way that might help you remember the definition for average value is to think about what do you do when you find the average of test scores. Let's say you have 4 tests. You know that you add them up and then you divide by 4 the number of tests. Well, to find the average value of a function, you find the value of the definite integral, and essentially you divide by the length of the interval, which would be b minus a. Remember, dividing by b minus a is the same as multiplying by 1 over b minus a, or the reciprocal. Another way to think of it would be in terms of area. If we had a function that was non-negative and continuous, we know that if we integrate this function from a to b, that would be the area of the shaded region. Well, if we take the average value formula and multiply both sides by b minus a, we would have b minus a times y sub av is equal to this definite integral, which would be the area. So what we're saying here is that the area of this rectangle, which would be the average value times the length of the interval, would give us the area of this rectangle, which would be the same area as the shaded region under the function. And of course, you could also think of the average value as the average height of the function over a given interval, since the average value is a y value. Let's go ahead and give it a try. We want to find the average value of this function on this interval. So the average value would equal 1 over b minus a. Here's our a value, here's our b values. So 4 minus negative 4 would be 8. So we have 1/8 times the definite integral from negative 4 to 4 of our function, and we integrate with respect to x. So this would give us 1/8 times 16x minus x cubed divided by 3. And when you evaluate this at 4 and negative 4 and then find the difference. So we'll first replace x with 4, and then with negative 4, we would have 1/8. Simplifying here, we would have 128/3. And over here, we'd have negative 128/3, which would be 1/8 times 256/3, which is equal to 32/3, or 10 2/3. So the average value of this function on the interval from negative 4 to 4 would be 10/3. As mentioned before, another way to think of this would be to think, if we let the height of this rectangle be 10/3 and the width be 8, the area of this rectangle would be the same area of the gray shaded region. And we can also think of the average value as the average height of this green function on the interval from negative 4 to 4. Let's take a look at an application of this. A solar panel manufacturer determines that its marginal revenue per day is given by this function, where the total revenue when t equals 0 is 0. The company also determines that its marginal cost per day is given by this function, where the total cost when t equals 0 is equal to 0. We want to answer two questions. Find the total profit from t equals 0 to t equals 10, and then find the average daily profit for the first 10 days. Okay, so the first question says, find the total profit for t equals 0 to t equals 10 days. Essentially, what we're trying to find is the total profit for the first 10 days, which would be p of 10, but we don't have p of 10, and we don't even have the marginal profit function, but we do have marginal revenue and marginal cost. Since the difference of marginal revenue and marginal cost would give us marginal profit, what we can do is we can integrate the difference of the marginal revenue and the marginal cost from t equals 0 to 10. Since we know the total profit would be equal to the total revenue when t is 10 minus the total cost when t is 10. It might help to think of this integral undoing the derivative. So the total profit for the first 10 days would be equal to the definite integral of marginal revenue minus marginal cost from t equals 0 to 10. Let's simplify this. We'd have 75 e to the t. Here we have 2t terms. So we're going to have negative 2t minus negative 3t, or a positive t, and then minus 75, and we'll integrate this with respects to t. Let's go to the next screen and do that. Here are the integration formulas we need to apply. So we'd have 75 e to the t plus t squared divided by 2 minus 75t, and we'll evaluate this at 10 and 0 and then find the difference. So we first replace t with 10, then replace t with 0 and simplify. This simplifies to $1,651,284.94 minus $75, giving us the total profit for the first 10 days of $1,651,209.94. Another way to look at this would be if we had the graph of the marginal profit function. Remember, marginal profit is profit per day. We found the area under this function from 0 to 10, it would equal the total revenue, or big P of 10, over the first 10 days. Okay, now to find the average daily profit for the first 10 days, we want to find the average value of the marginal profit. Be careful not to use the profit function because we're trying to find the average daily profit. So let's go ahead and set this one up. The average daily profit would equal 1 over B minus A. Well, B is 10 and A is 0, so we'd have 1/10 times the definite integral of the marginal profit function with respect to t. Now, we just calculated this on the last problem, so what we have to do is multiply 1/10 times the total profit for the first 10 days. Or if you remember from earlier in the semester when we were finding average profit, we just took the total profit function and divided by x, since this definite integral does represent p of 10. Dividing by 10 would move the decimal place to the left 1 unit. So our average daily profit would be $165,120.99 per day for the first 10 days. Let's take a look at a graph. Again, in blue, we have our marginal profit function. The y value of this red horizontal line represents the average daily profit. So the area of this slim rectangle down here would be the same area as the area under the marginal profit function. I hope this video helped. Thank you for watching.